What I have in mind is to present you with a couple of detailed ideas on building a connected continent. And we all are aware, and that is fascinating, by the way, that the world is going digital and that it is not a matter of are you in favor, yes or no, but it's a fact of life, so to say. And it is a growing market, a growing global market, and that is giving perspective. And we are looking for perspective in pushing the economy and pushing the number of jobs. And we are facing the real important question, what type of future economy does Europe have in mind? Our telecom sector and our ICT ecosystem, once the envy of the world, so to say, are not competing. And that is making me sad, but also making me in a fighting spirit. And I'm certain that we have in common that type of feeling. Our citizens and businesses face barriers and unfair charges. And that is supposed to be a global network. But it faces border checkpoints, even within our single market. And having that said that, I always explain to outsiders that the single market is one of the crown jewels of the European Union, and that we are proud of that. But taking into account that one economic field is excluded from that single market so far, talking about telecom, talking about that sector that is so important and is so related with all the other economic activities. So if we are really in favor for just implementing the single market also for this field, we have to do our job. The rest of the world, by the way, is racing ahead. That is also a fact, and that is not with pleasure that I'm mentioning that. And by the way, I'm always in a mood to say if another one is having an opportunity, take it, but that is stimulating us to take our opportunities too. Talking about, for example, the United States, Japan, Korea, South America. America, Japan, and Korea have 88% of the world's 4G subscriptions. And we only have 6% versus 88%. And meanwhile, only 2% of European homes have super-fast broadband. Those problems badly need solutions. And I intend, Madame le Président, a package to do that, due first thing in September. And it will bring down borders. It will stimulate investment. It make it easier to operate and communicate across the EU, building on our existing framework, boosting our connected continent in three key ways. Number one, for truly European networks, it must be easier to communicate across borders without operators facing a tangle of different, incompatible rules. And if you are allowed to operate anywhere in Europe, authorized within an EU framework, then you should be able to operate everywhere in the EU. And I don't just mean, Madame le Président, possible, but straightforward in practice, so to say. Like a single authorization system with supervision by the home member state and more chance for the Commission to ensure consistent remedies. Less red tape and less cost, less hassle, and that is what a single market means. And that is not a cabadabra. That is reality if we are making it serious. And that's the boost they already have in sectors from banking to broadcasting. Now, we only need to do it for telecoms too. Second, the operators need inputs, the networks to run on. And again, as it stands, that's too hard, especially across borders. We need more consistent ways to access fixed networks, like standardizing ways to access networks, so-called virtual bitstream products, and with interconnection services that guarantee quality. and guaranteed quality, ladies and gentlemen. Plus, for wireless, we need better spectrum rules. Spectrum bands need more consistent license conditions, like how long license lasts, block sizes, fee structures, and so on and so forth. And all those things will make it easier to run a network over multiple countries and easier to enjoy high-quality services over them. And third, our citizens need to enjoy fair rights and a fair deal across the Union, including the right to net neutrality. Blocking or throttling services isn't just unfair and annoying for users, it is death sentence for innovators too. So I will guarantee net neutrality. And with more transparency, so you know what's in your contract, and making it easier to switch providers, allowing the new premium services, which so many new services rely on, from cloud computing to e-health and so forth. And I will end anti-competitive blocking and throttling for every citizen on every network, on every device. Internet growth depends on openness, on innovation, and I will provide an absolute safeguard. A fair deal includes, by the way, fairer prices. European calls shouldn't count as a costly international call, not within a true single market. It's connected with a single market when there is no roaming. European calls shouldn't count as such a costly international call. You shouldn't face a sudden price hike just to call across an internal border. So any difference in price must be objectively justified by additional cost. And of course, in a true single market, there are no artificial roaming charges. It is irritating. It is unfair. It belongs to the past. Roaming connected with an artificial border is not acceptable. Often, the only remaining reminder of our internal borders is the phone in your pocket. You know, normally spoken, not when you are passing a border, but the noise of your phone remembers, and that has to change. Millions of Europeans enjoy great transparent packages on their mobile subscription. They expect to pay once and have everything included, not just when they are at home, but when they travel too. They should be able to take their mobile minutes, messages, megabytes with them wherever they travel in Europe. And I know you raised the issue of roaming in the draft report from Mr. Rode. And congratulations, Mr. Rode. You did a great job. But let me remind you of one thing. It's not by banning roaming charges that we create a single market. Quite the opposite. It is by creating a single market that we will end roaming surcharges. A market where companies face the same competitive pressure to push down roaming prices as they do it at home on their own network. A market where they can attract and keep customers by adding roaming to the competitive bundles they offer. A market where consumers enjoy choice and competition, not borders and barriers. And that is how I want to turn today's fragmented reality into a true competitive single market. And that fragmentation isn't about some breach of EU dogma. It has real consequences. To take just one example, spectrum. Countries are not following their obligations to assign spectrum. But even when it is assigned, each does it differently, so it's harder to bid, to plan, to offer services across borders. It's harder for manufacturers to optimize their new gadgets for Europe. It is harder for business to benefit from single market economies of scale. uncertainties and costs faced by operators are passed on to consumers, meaning higher prices and poorer service. European manufacturers who once led the world today struggle to compete. And it's not that long ago, Madame le Président, that they were leading that market, that world, the European manufacturers. It was in the 90s, so to say. And that is not just about one sector, not just about phones and tablets, not anymore. Soon, all sorts of devices could be connected, from your car to your health service and so on. And there is a massive opportunity for people to enjoy pan-European services that work widely, but they are still waiting. And I'm not just looking at one sector. I'm looking at the whole picture. The European telecom sector and ICT ecosystem are keystones of our economy, and I'd like to see them stronger. A strong telecom sector that stands up for itself in a competitive market, less reliant on regulation, but not for their sake. This is in everyone's interest. The fact is, the whole economy is relying on digital tools and networks. Sectors from banking to logistics, automotive to audiovisual. And beyond that, all kinds of companies are crying out for the connectivity that could transform their business, from video conferencing to cloud computing to 3D printing. And companies of every size, in every sector, are at stake. They are fed up with not having them. We can't leave them stranded. We have to act. They have European ambitions. We can't leave them without the communications to match. And we have European ambitions too. In an economy relying on information and on communication, we can't sit by while the telecom sector becomes too weak to compete, too weak to invest, too weak to innovate. And we can't continue to struggle by with poor aging networks. And that matters. The boost from a competitive single market in telecommunications could be, by the way, 110 billion euros a year. Quality communications for business could be worth 800 billion over 15 years. Broadband could create 2 million jobs, and that is investing in tomorrow's growth. My ambition is large scale, but my approach is pragmatic. Today, our networks and regulations are largely national. Fact, a pragmatic approach is not about digging up those networks, tearing up those rule books, and starting again from scratch. No, it's about taking what we have and adapting it, unblocking the bottlenecks, bringing down the barriers, giving operators, giving businesses, giving citizens the single market boost, better services, faster networks, and fairer prices. And I know that you have just been discussing a long-term option, a more comprehensive review of the entire ecosystem as proposed in Mrs. Trautmann's report. And I can see the attraction of that. But here is my advice. Let's not miss the opportunity. Also to Mrs. Trautmann. Let's not miss this opportunity to make a real difference to growth and employment. Realistically, such a full review would take 5 years. I can't explain that to all those youngsters that are looking for a job. I can't explain that we should wait. And those days, lost time means lost opportunity. And think how the world has changed in the last 5 years. It's remarkable and it's fascinating. The devices you didn't have 5 years, the services that didn't exist, and now we take it for granted. Think how the world will change in the next 5. And then think if we can afford to wait that long, while other parts of the world race ahead. Instead, I'm putting forward an incremental but immediate approach, improving the model to get the best out of the current framework, taking a significant step towards a single market, where technology and service convergence are part of the new reality, and where an updated regulatory framework takes account of those dynamic changes, and where we can take the time to reflect on and then implement the regulatory framework we need for the future. But first, let's get the telecom single market right. Let's get it working for Europe. And that's my alternative. And, Madame la Présidente, I'm giving you this current parliament, an instrument to offer more immediate benefits to our people and to our economy. Fewer barriers, more choice, fairer prices, better business services, net neutrality, and an end to roaming, a stronger economy creating more jobs. And that's the benefits of a connected, competitive continent. And I think it's worth fighting for that. And if you believe in Europe, believe in this fight with that result, I would love to do it together. Thank you.
Grazie.